What's up, guys? This is Adam with TAT Express, and in this video, I'm gonna go over common issues on a DD15. If you own a DD15, this video is made for you. Make sure to like, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you know next time we release another video. Let's get right into this video. Okay, guys, I'm gonna break this video down in three different sections: the top, the middle, and the bottom. The first thing I'm gonna talk about is the rocker box. This rocker box, where the rocker box meets the head, there's a seal there that always goes out. You're gonna have oil leaking all around the engine. So one thing I'd like to mention about that particular job is you wanna make sure you use an experienced shop. You're gonna have to remove the dual overhead cams, make sure everything's timed, and be very clean. If you get any dirt in this engine, or if you put the engine off time, you can definitely cause some damage. So make sure you're using somebody that has some experience. The next item I'd like to talk about are these gaskets here on these fuel lines. When this rocker box starts to leak, it's good to go ahead and replace these gaskets and go ahead and put new lines on there. Some people like to reuse these lines, but one thing I'd like to mention is we do a high pressure test during the repair on the fuel system. And what we look for is when we have the fuel pressure up during operating conditions, we look for fuel leaks. And then most of the time when we reuse the lines, we'll have some leakage there. So it's a good idea to get those lines replaced. One more item I want to mention about up top: if you have irregular noise that's going on up top, make sure to shut that engine down and have it looked at. The valve train needs to be adjusted at every 500 k. The next item I want to talk about is the head. The most common problem you're going to see is injector cups. And the way you could tell is you'll have fuel in your cooling system. Now, you want to make sure it gets troubleshot correctly before condemning parts. This piece right here, right now, we have the intake manifold removed, but the intake manifold runs here. Common issues you can see is a gasket leak here, right here between the manifold and the head. And there's also a throttle valve that's gonna be on that. That is an electrical throttle valve, and over time it's gonna give you some faults. That throttle intake manifold can be tested by a computer, but so be sure to troubleshoot before condemning the part. So now we're on the exhaust side of the engine. We have the exhaust manifold and the water manifold removed. Above that is gonna be an EGR cooler. That's an item that gets clogged, or it actually ruptures and you're gonna have pressure in your exhaust system. What you wanna look for is indication, decoloration, and your degas bottle. Any of these gaskets can leak, the water manifold gasket or the exhaust manifold gasket. Since the exhaust manifold is removed here, there is an EGR valve that's hooked up here. It's a butterfly valve that's being controlled by an actuator. And there's coolant that runs through that actuator. That actuator fails pretty often, so you're gonna have to get that replaced. Look out for that. The turbo is gonna be set right here. There's not a lot of things that go on with the turbo. It's a pretty solid unit. If you do have oil passing, be sure to troubleshoot well before condemning the turbo. Now let's talk about the center part of the engine. On the older style engine, you have our auxiliary turbine that's bolted back here. A lot of the newer engines are gonna have just that block off plate. That turbine there, if you do have one, it could be problematic. Down here is your crankcase filter. A lot of times the crankcase filter is gonna leak where the gasket's coming from. If you replace that and you still have high crankcase pressure, that engine needs to be shot for high crankcase pressure. We're gonna move back over to the driver's side. Stay in the middle section of the engine. I wanna talk about the fuel system. So now we're on the driver's side of the engine. We're gonna still stay on the middle part. The first thing I wanna talk about is oil leaks. Okay, so your fuel pump goes here and your air pump is down here. A lot of times you're gonna have the pump actually leak through the housing. That's a pretty large job. As you can see, everything's pretty much removed right now, but you have a fuel filter housing that goes here. That's a pretty large item as well. So it's very important to get an experienced shop to work on any of these items, because you can cause a lot of damage. We've seen fuel pumps installed incorrectly. Those need to be timed. We've actually seen fuel filter modules get installed incorrectly. Another item I would like to mention: if you have a three filter system, those items are actually gonna be discontinued. Everything now is gonna be a two filter system. Staying on the fuel pump, I want to advise you guys to go ahead and replace that fuel filter less than 15,000 miles. You don't want to go over that. A lot of places are not getting tested for fuel, so you can have a lot of condensation where you fuel at. So it's a good practice to change out these fuel filters. In addition, it's always good to change out that air dryer filter so you can save your air compressor. That's a pretty large job. This engine, of course, is out of the truck, but replacing the air pump can be very challenging. The next thing I'd like to cover is your oil cooler module. Now this is a pretty large unit. If it starts to leak, that's a pretty common issue. When you get this type of repair done, be sure that you're using an experienced shop because you could contaminate the oil and cause some issues with your mains. Also, make sure when you're changing your oil filter, be sure to check the standpipe up whenever you're changing out your oil filter to ensure you don't have any damage on that. Your thermostat is something that's gonna be commonly replaced as well, and also your water pump, that's gonna be pretty common. Up under the oil cooler module is going to be your oil pressure sensor. If you see this sensor leak, you want to go ahead and replace it because it would cause a bad communication and have your truck shut off. The last thing I want to discuss is the bottom half of the engine. Of course, we're going to discuss the low oil pressure problem. Now, when you check these manifolds out, if they're not cracked, you can reuse them. The tubes are reusable as well, replacing the O-rings. You don't have to replace the pump. Usually just doing that is a good job. What's most important is that you have an experienced shop that does this type of work, because I've seen some trucks with engines locked up having someone do this type of work that doesn't have the experience working on DD15, so it's very important. Another item is you can have your gasket of your oil pan leaking as well, and your front seal leaking. Those are pretty common items that you want to look for. The last item I'd like to mention is your flywheel. The flywheel has a key on it, so we have seen people put the flywheel on incorrectly. So again, guys, be sure you're using an experienced shop on doing any of these type of repairs. They look pretty simple, but if you don't follow the procedures and you use a shop that without the right experience, it could cost you some major, major engine problems. Well, guys, I hope you liked the video. If you'd like to schedule an appointment to get your truck checked out, you can call us at 972-225-3017. Make sure to like, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you know next time we release another video. If you'd like to share your experience, leave it in the comments below. And until next time, guys, be safe.